All this work that we're doing, brothers, for this ministry, eventually is going to pay off. You better believe it, man. It's going to pay off like you'll never believe, okay? And by the way, we're the highest value male on this planet, the men of the Lord, the men of this truth, the hopeful elect of Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, the highest value male there is.
All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I'd like to give all praise and glory to Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, Baal Shem Rakakadash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of GMS who rule well, teach well, being great examples to us younger brothers in peace and blessing and salutation. Hopefully, they got that pushing his word in truth and in sincerity across the four winds in the name of Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, pushing to get up out of here. Shalom to the hopefully the believers, the listeners whom have came back to the obedience of the scriptures through faith in Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai. All right, and what I want to get into, how this society is being confounded, all right, by this word, okay? As this word is going forth throughout the earth, what's happening, the strongholds of this wicked society is being brought down, all right? And this society is being made to look very foolish, okay? Because for the longest, you know, people, you know, have accepted, you know, wickedness, you know, as the norm, you know, people... You know, a lot of wickedness went unchecked, you know, women, you know, it went unchecked. Street culture was popular and cute, you know, but now, you know, these things are being called out. OK, the alphabet community, you know, is a war on it. OK, because, you know, Esau just taking everything too far. And what's happened is he has created a society where the masses of people have pretty much destroyed themselves, man. You know, this society. You know, this beast system, all right, Westernization has destroyed masses, man. You know, and that's why it's a blessing the Lord has pulled us out and started dealing and started healing, man. You know, with the hopeful elect, all right. But there's a lot of people that this society has just completely destroyed, man. And more so the woman, you know, the woman giving their liberty, all right, to pretty much to be her own overseer. And they've destroyed themselves, man. You know, this year alone, you know, I'm just looking at things and analyzing, you know, as I have more time to think now, you know, and just looking at it, women have completely destroyed themselves, man, in this society, man, for the most part. The majority of women have just run themselves to the ground, man, okay, to the point there's nothing left, you know, and it's all under, all right, this society and these enchantments. So I want to get a couple of precepts and then I got a video to play. All right, I'm gonna let it play after. This is Jeremiah 50:1. It says, the word that the Lord spake against Babylon, all right, and this is speaking this Babylon, and against the land of the Chaldeans by Jeremiah the prophet, okay? And the Chaldeans were the ancient warlocks and witches, all right, the left-hand priesthood, all right, they ran the Neo-Babylonian Empire, okay? And today it's the elites and the higher-ups that are the Chaldeans, the modern-day Chaldeans, because all the enchantments, all right, that dominate the earth, you know, all the wickedness that dominates the earth comes from their doing through media, through propaganda, through TV, through entertainment, through music, okay, the school curriculum, okay? They created a rebellious society, all right? And but now it's being confounded by this word. All right. That's why you get Jeremiah 50:20 said, declare ye among the nations and publish and set up a standard. Publish and conceal not. Say Babylon is taken. And see, what is the standard that's being set up? This word. OK, now there's a standard being set up against this place. For the longest, there was no standard. It was just American culture just making it up as you go. Okay, and that's why every decade, the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, the 90s, all right, the 2000s just kept getting perpetually worse and worse and worse because there was no standard. But now there's a standard lifted up against this devil, man, all right? And it's making this culture seem very foolish. It's making Westernization seem extremely foolish, man, okay? All right, so you go into the Hebrew, it's the Hebrew word is Nasah. All right, and it says a sick something lifted up, a standard, okay, a banner, signal pole, okay, standard is a rallying point, and who is that rallying point? Yahweh Shai, okay, That's the rallying point for the elect. So as we're being rallied by this standard now, all right, as we look out in society, we see how off it is. We see how off we was, man. You know, like now we really see, and the Lord is showing us more and more, all right, how off this society is, man. All right, and how how wickedness can ruin the earth, man. You see, but the standard is being lifted up in the spirit, okay? And now this place is being confounded. It's being revealed for what it is. All right, it says publish and conceal not. Okay, and that's what we're doing. That's why we constantly teaching. We constantly going into things. We constantly going into this society, going into this history, going into the origin of things, going into the witchcraft that's interwoven and all. You know, we going into these things, man. You know, we're publishing it. It says Baal is confounded. Merodach is broken in pieces. Her idols are confounded. Her images are broken in pieces, man. And that's what's happening. And Merodach was one of the main deities of ancient, all right, Babylon, all right, the Neo-Babylon Empire, okay? And you go to Marduk, okay, which is Merodach in the Hebrew. And what does it say? Thy rebellion, okay? Thy rebellion. You see, and society has rebelled against, and society has been in a rebellion against righteousness for a long time, man. You know, and it really amplified in the 60s, man. Okay? The earth is in the great rebellion under Esau Edom. And that's the image of the beast, all right, is the ideology of a rebellion against righteousness, man. And there's a lot of things within that, man. Okay, but it's being confounded, it's being broken down, it's being brought to naught. Okay, you see, you go here to first, let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and see the Lord is using, all right, what society, you know, looks at as nothing, all right, to do it. You see, it says 1 Corinthians 1 and 26, it says, for you see your calling, brethren. All right. How there not many wise men after the flesh. All right. After this world standards with degrees. Okay. Accolades. You know, not many mighty, not many noble, which is, you know, the higher ups, man. Okay. Are called. But the Most High have chosen the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. And the Most have chosen the weak things of this world to confound the things which are mighty. Because here it is, we're everyday working citizens, everyday working men. And we're confounding the enchantments that's coming from trillionaires, man, from up top, man. You know, that's the power of this word. That's the Lord showcasing the power of his word through his men. And his men are in the lower state. Okay? Making this place seem foolish, man. You know, brothers, some brothers ain't even finished high school, man, and they going in, okay? Got Esau society looking crazy as hell, man. Westernization looking crazy and foolish as hell, man. Okay, verse 28, and base things of the world and things which are despised have the Most High chosen, yeah, and things which are not to bring to naught things that are, okay, because when you read in NLT, it says the Most High chose things despised by the world, things counted as nothing at all. Yeah, because when you look at it, here it is as a nation, Israel, we're last, you know, according to the prophecy, we will be last, you know, according to the curses. All right. But within the, you know, the ranking system of of Israel, what do you have? You have the woman. OK, because Israel is ran by a matriarch at this point. All right. Our people in the world is ran by a matriarch, man. You know, nigga culture, black people is ran by a matriarch. You know, let me retract that, because Israel. All right. The believers, you know, now we've been established in the patriarch, man. You know, but black people are ran by what? A matriarch. OK, so you have the women at the top, and then those women. Under the women, what do you have? Street niggas, degenerate niggas, okay? And then you have what? The working class Israelite, which is considered as nothing, you know, in this society, because here it is, Jacob, we are at the last as a nation, but we under the bottom of the bottom. But it's beautiful. You know, I love it. You know, I love it because I know what's to come. You see, it says the Most High chose things despised by the world, things counted as nothing at all, and used them to bring to nothing what the world considers important. Okay, what the world considers important. You see, for the longest time, people thought being a strong, independent woman was the thing to be. They deemed that important. They looked at Christianity as important. Okay, Christianity was like, you know, they're deadly serious, man. Okay, Egyptologists, all these things are being confounded. Everything that our people thought was important, you know, I say street niggas, they, you know, things that we thought was everything, man, is being confounded by this word, man, and just looking foolish, man. Okay, so I'm gonna let the video play, and at the end of the day, we gotta get our mind out the west, man. Okay, get out the west or get left, man. And that's for all of us, man. We gotta get completely out of Western culture, man, and tap back in, man, to our culture, man, and righteousness, man. Shalom.
Why are men so concerned with women's body count? But men's body count are twice as much, but obviously don't matter.
Well, here's the thing. You have to understand that there's a great difference between males and females. Men and women are not the same. You are not equal. You, okay? Men mark their territory. The higher your body count is, the less likely he can bond you and bind you to him as his property, right? Men are takers by nature. They take energy. That's what they do. So the more men that you're with, the more value you lose because you got so many men taken from you, right? After they didn't took so much from you, what do you have to offer after that? Nothing. So as a woman, why would you want a high body count?
Now, this is the problem. We have modern women that have nothing else to offer except for their looks. When their looks start to fade and go, older women would say, you know what, you might need to act a little different. You're supposed to move different. You're a mom now. Like, guys, I don't think it's crazy that we don't do the same thing at 16 that we do at 30.
Every day is pleasure, pleasure, pleasure. So what happens is the brain starts to seek pleasure rather than peace. And when men or women, when they meet someone peaceful, they label it as boring. And they're always seeking somebody who gives them some form of pleasure or dopamine. And the best person that gives you dopamine is a toxic attachment. What happens with a toxic attachment is you get preoccupied with that person. You're thinking about them, where are they, why haven't they called, blah, blah, blah. And that toxic attachment, they mislabel that as love. And it's just preoccupation. So they forget to look for peace. They consider somebody where it's boring, simple, monotonous.
It just sounds like just men always just want virgins that hadn't had sex with anyone and are really good girls. Like you want younger women as well, so it's like that whole predator vibes. That's it.
You're what if I said women are stupid, can't make money, short and weak because they want a guy that makes more money than them, taller than them, more confident, ambitious, etc. That would be ludicrous, wouldn't it? Because I'm demonizing what you want, but we don't do that with women, do we? We don't shame female preferences. Okay, when a woman says, I want a man that's tall, makes money, etc., you go, girl, you deserve it. That's your preferences. If I say, I want a girl that's not a hoe, that has some, you know, sexual temperance, that's considered, oh, that's toxic and masculine, etc. We demonize male preferences, but we don't demonize female preferences.
This is what other people are not telling y'all. I've dated these girls, he's dated these girls. Most of them are headaches.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, don't put all your eggs in one basket. Like, yo, I need a really bad blah, blah, blah. Are y'all prepared for her to be an attention whore? Are you guys prepared for her to want to be around her friends all the time and do whole shit? Are you guys prepared for her to not clean up your place after you went to the gym for an hour or two and you come back and she's just on her phone looking at her Instagram? Are you guys prepared for her to be a narcissistic, annoying bimbo? Are y'all prepared for her to stop by every single mirror that she walks by to look at herself? Are y'all prepared for her to take 3 hours to get dressed? Are y'all prepared for her to, you know, introduce you to her social circle of friends who annoy the fuck out of you because they're useless as well? Are y'all prepared for this? Real talk. This is just some of the things that come along with dealing with a really bad bitch.
Yeah.
That most of y'all are not prepared to handle.
Would you get into a relationship with a woman that was over the age of 35 that wanted kids and knowing this is a possibility?
We don't take baby moms around here.
I do not have sympathy for you chicks, yeah? When you get old, you hit the wall and then you start complaining, oh, where has all the good men gone? Bruv, you had the good men, they're in your friend zone, in your best years, bro. You chasing bad boys and drug dealers and rappers and YouTubers and all of these kind of people, bruv, at the end of the day, you only got yourself to blame, fam.
I mean, you got 100+ men telling you here that they prefer women to have lower body counts.
Yeah, all of them are delusional.
This is the quintessential example of what I mean when I say female standards are respected and supposed to be adhered to, whereas male standards are considered delusional. Let me ask you a question. Would you say that in general, most women prefer a man taller than themselves?
Yeah, that's true.
Would it be fair to say that in general, women prefer a man that makes more money than them?
Yes, I guess.
In general. Would it be fair to say that women want a guy that is more confident and ambitious than themselves?
Yeah, those things, yes.
Okay, what if I said that women are delusional for these inherent standards?
I don't think it's delusional to have those standards.
Stop the show right there. I don't think it's delusional that they want women that have low body counts.
Yeah, but why?
Hold on, stop the show.
The reason.
The more bodies you get as a girl, the more your value goes down.
What? And what about a man?
The more girls I fuck, my value goes up. The more guys you fuck, your value goes down.
No.
It's like, nah, bro. No.
It's crazy. What the Because you a lot of girls, your value goes down?
Goes up.
It goes up?
If you a lot of guys, your value goes down. Oh, it doesn't matter?
No, it doesn't.
Okay, what's your body count then?
I'm not going to say it.
Exactly.
Oh. I could.
If you didn't care and it didn't matter, you would say your body count. But it does matter, which is why you don't want to say it.
No, it's just because it's private. I don't want to say it on the internet because like people are dumb and they're going to be like, I don't know. It's just.
But that means it matters.
It's my life. But that means it doesn't matter. People are just dumb.
That's my point.
I can say it.
That means it matters.
I can say it. I don't care.
Say what?
Okay, 13.
Cap.
I swear to God.
You don't know. Why is it that these women that have 300 credit scores, aka 300 fucking bodies, want to deal with you after you busted your ass to create capital, become a millionaire, become a fucking somebody, get your shit together, hit the gym, go through the trials and tribulations of life to go ahead and sit there and accept someone that has not taken the same level of discipline in making sure that their past is clean? Think about that for a second. You bust your ass to create a future, yet she's completely in control of all her actions, makes bad decisions, and she expects you to save her from her bad decisions. No!
This birth control allowed hoes to be hoes. Then, the provider, the hoes don't pick the providers, they pick the chads. Then, no-fault divorce allowed the hoes to leave. Then, the government funded them leaving. And then social media made girls that are sixes think they're nines and tens and deserve nines and tens and think they're too good for the guy that's on their level, and then they marry the guy that's on their level, and then they're thinking about these guys and they're like, damn, I wish I could have had those guys. And so what they do is they break up their home because they think they can do better and they can't. But then what happens? At the end of the day, there's no consequence because of you simps who bail them out. Class dismissed.
All right, ladies, why men are shying away from commitment. Let's get into it. And please don't be offended. Number one, social media. Social media makes you think you have a surplus available options. And I say makes you think you have because the appearance of may not be the reality. Hookup culture. Men don't have to commit to you to get the benefits of that connection. So because of that, why get into a relationship? And unfortunately, because men think that there are lower quality women on the market today. Due to perspectives, higher body counts, maybe even personality traits, men think that women today are of lower quality and therefore do not want to commit, or are more apprehensive to commit, should I say.
I didn't say I didn't have family or children. I just said it's none of your business.
Oh, I see. Okay.
I might have multiple family. Oh. You never know. I might like family more than you. So much I have five.
Do you think that's a good thing to have multiple families?
I think it's good if there's one dad and there's not a bunch of step-parents involved and the dad can be the hero and those five families live a 10x better life than they would have otherwise. Yes, ma'am, I do.
But you don't think that it will be ultimately an opportunity for jealousy or disharmony amongst
women? Are always
going to
be jealous. What's changed
I'm
about
not jealous
that? Women
in
have been
marriage.
Jealous all the way through time. So.
I'm not jealous in my marriage.
Like, I don't care about your marriage. I'm talking about mine. Mm-hmm. Well, my life is going to be, so I don't answer to you. So That's my answer. I'm going to run my situation exactly how I want to. And generally, when I do that, that's when I have the most happiness, let's say, in my life. So, that's all.
Can I ask you one more question?
Fire away, honey.
Okay. if you have only one place in your heart for one woman, or you want to have one woman in your heart, I think you said, why don't you just commit to one and choose to be faithful to her?
I'm just not wired that way. I spent my whole 20s trying to fix myself.
Thought you're something a man of self-control. You work out, you do business.
Yeah.
You can possess your own power and do not, direct just, it the way you want to direct it.
It's not how I am. It's not how I am.
You think that might be a limited mindset?
I think it's none of your business, but I don't want you to think I'm triggered by you. I'm not. Okay. I saw somebody say that, and I think that's interesting. I think you're annoying, but I'm not triggered. You know what I'm saying? No, you are. You're annoying in like this goody two-shoes type way, and that's fine. I'm going to live my life on my terms, unapologetically, like truly. So you can ask me this 85 different ways. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, I'm going to walk out of here the same man.
Dear Steve Harvey, ever since you told women to act like a lady and think like a man, I've been seeing more women take their own trash out. Reposting Justin Lil Boy and how they don't need a man, but got their cash up in the bio asking for a handout. I mean, you say you want a man, but you ain't doing nothing to stand out. Remember, Gina still got married to Martin. Y'all rather take the Tommy and Pam route. I mean, you say you want a man, but you just want an enabler. That's going to tell you you're right in every situation. You want a traditional man to pay your traditional rent, but you got a modern day attitude and a modern generation. It don't work like that. And half the men you talk to ain't got jobs and don't work like that. I mean, you say you want a provider, but all you got to bring to the table is baggage, and it's okay as long as it's a Birkin bag. Talking about how with the right man, you naturally going to submit. Man, you got a reality TV show attitude. Ain't no man going to deal with that shit. But I...